guys, time for Hot Topics. Let's do it.
Hi guys, so today I want to share another story with you. Today I want to talk about Love & Hip Hop Hollywood. What is Monique Slaughter's real problem? Okay guys, I just don't want to do this article today, but somebody had to do it. Somebody had to do it. So why not me? I mean, that's my job, right? It's about time that someone talked about the beautiful, sick puppy that goes by the nickname Monique Slaughter. Let's talk about this interview that sick puppy gave about her music and what we think ultimately, if anybody can get to the bottom of it, is her real problem. And when I say sick puppy, it's no shade. It's no shade. It's just ice to cool down her supporters, okay? But we all know, you know, something's kind of wrong with Monique, at least in my opinion. And if you disagree, then be prepared to state your case in my comment section without whining about it, okay? I hate whiners, okay? And sick puppies. I mean real sick puppies, you know, not Monique, you know, I mean the little puppies, you know. Anyway, let's move on. So Sick Puppy recently granted an interview in which she was promoting her new song on iTunes. And in the interview, she says, "I was groomed by the best. My dad made sure I understand not just to tap into my creativity, but the business itself. And I definitely intend to make sure that people know just how talented I am." Now, oddly enough, Sick Puppy might have all kind of weird shenanigans going on the show, but she's not a liar. She really can sing. I will give her that. She goes on to say, "I'm not just a reality star who woke up and decided to sing for shits and giggles. I'm a singer who happened to end up on reality TV." Okay, she's not lying. As I said previously, this girl can blow. She can really, really sing. I mean, Sick Puppy has everything that it factor that is required to be a bona fide star. You need to know how to sing. You have to be beautiful. You have to have the Whitney Houston it factor. And I will say Sick Puppy has that. But let me tell you why I will never purchase a Sick Puppy single. And this is not to be mean. This is my opinion, people. You have your own damn opinion. But let's get to the storylines that they have going on Love & Hip Hop Hollywood, which prevents me from buying a Sick Puppy single for at least 10 years. Like, I'm gonna need Sick Puppy to get big and fat where I don't recognize who she is and I just say, "Oh, that's a nice song. Who is that?" And then when they show me the picture, I don't even recognize that it's Monique Slaughter. I mean, it was apparent from the first moment Monique stepped onto the television screen that she had a huge cuss you out fight problem. Like, it's her solution for everything. She doesn't like, you know, how McDonald's fixed, you know, their new Big Mac. She's going to cuss them out and beat them up. That's what her solution is for everything. And it was cute at first, you know, about the first 2 months. And then I started saying, "Can we get past this, please?" She has a huge anger problem that she refuses to do anything about. And that leads us up to the storyline this season, which probably was the most pathetic thing I ever seen on television myself. You can have your own opinion, which she tried to beat up Princess Love, a pregnant woman. And that's no shade. It's just ice to anyone who doesn't mind a pregnant woman getting beat up. I mean, maybe that's your thing. Maybe you like watching the ID channel or something. And she basically tried to beat up Princess because Princess and Ray J's family have a problem with Monique's family for initiating Monique's brother DJ, who has a substance abuse problem, back to substance abuse. They think Brandy was the sole reason he returned to substance abuse, okay? And it's not just on the show that these outbursts occur. I mean, Monique's mother, who also shows signs of anger issues, took it to social media, calling Brandy out. They even took this issue to the Dr. Phil show, in which Dr. Phil kind of leaned towards, he thought that Monique's brother's substance abuse problem was so bad that it possibly could have led to mental illness, okay? And to be honest, people, even Dr. Phil's show was hard to watch. They brought their chaos and confusion to the Dr. Phil show. I mean, people were yelling over each other. Monique walked off the stage. It was just chaos to the point that there really wasn't much Dr. Phil could do. And of course, the whole thing ended with a big old cuss out from Moniece, by the way, who couldn't physically beat up Dr. Phil, so she just gave him a good cuss out on social media. Of course, there's a famous of her stalking the famous R&B singer Tank after having a one-night stand with him. Basically, she spazzed out on him. He couldn't get rid of her. She claimed pregnancy until he just couldn't take it anymore. I mean, this girl has some problems, some real problems. Then there's an even more serious rumor out there that she's a substance abuser. I mean, that's pretty serious. Could that be her problem? I don't know. Then there's a rumor that she acts this way because she had to hide her sexuality for years, but that rumor really doesn't make any sense because she ended up coming out on the show and having a full-on girlfriend, AD, who I like, who she doesn't like so much because they end up breaking up a couple weeks ago. The rumor is AD just couldn't take it anymore. Whatever the case is, they're no longer together, and I thought she was a stabilizing force in Moniece's life. Other people feel that AD was just using her. I don't give a damn. I'm just tired of all the fighting. So because we're so early in the season, I felt it was time, people. It was time to ask the question, what the hell is Moniece's real problem, people? Because I can't figure it out. I really can't figure it out. And I know I have to put up with this for the rest of the season. And to make matters worse, she has teamed up with equally nut job Kay Michelle? Oh, God. No. I gotta get to the bottom of what is wrong with Moniece. Because if we don't, people, I hate to say it. I mean, I guess I don't hate to say it if I'm gonna say it, so let me say it. I don't see Moniece having a successful music career because of her crazy antics. And if you ask me what's wrong with her, I would probably say lack of control. Lack of control and lack of guidance at this point. That's my opinion. That's what I'm going to lay on the line. But I could be wrong. That's why this question needed to be addressed. And I'm tough enough to take it on. And for all you Moniece supporters who say, she has control, she has role models in her life, name me one person and then tell me what you think the problem is. Because I shouldn't be feeling this damn stressed out from watching a damn television show, okay? I really shouldn't. Also, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and that notification button for more stories like these. Until next time, talk to you then. Bye.